Hi guys, it's Caitlin, and today I am here to bring you my February wrap-up and my March TBR. So I'm just gonna apologize in advance for any like banging or drilling noises you hear. Right now, we have some construction going on in the basement. There's something wrong with how the lights are set up, so he's taking everything apart because some of it needs rewired. So the month of February was a great reading month for me. I managed to finish 5 books. I wish that I'd gotten through more, but I did have a little bit of a struggle with the first book that I completed this month, and after that it was just kind of hard to catch up. I'm still well beyond goal for my 2016 reading challenge on Goodreads, so let's go ahead and get started. The first book I completed this month was The Magicians by Lev Grossman. This is the first book in the Magicians trilogy, following a boy named Quentin, who discovers that he is a magician. He goes to magic college. This book covers his 5 years of magic college and then like the year-ish afterwards after he's graduated when he's just trying to figure things out. Unfortunately, I only gave this book 2 stars. It took me forever to get through. I found it very boring at times. I couldn't connect with any of the characters. I either didn't care about them or I actually straight up disliked them. I felt that the story kind of moved more slowly than I wanted it to. I felt like it sped through these 5 years and kind of glossed over the things that I found interesting and that I wanted to hear about. Then it slowed down to focus on things that I wasn't interested by. I mean, the ending was pretty good. That's why I gave it 2 stars instead of 1, because I really did like the last 100 pages or so. But overall, that wasn't enough to make up for the previous like 350 something pages. So unfortunately, I did give this one 2 stars. I probably won't be continuing on with the series, even though I am slightly tempted because it sounds like the rest of the series takes place in the same place that the last 100 pages of this book did, but I'm not sure if I want to risk it. The next book that I finished this month was Remembrance by Meg Cabot. This is the 7th book in the Mediator series, and this is actually the first adult installment. This series follows a girl named Suze. Suze is a mediator, meaning that she can see, speak to, and touch ghosts, and it's her job to get them to cross over whether they want to or not. I filmed a review of this book and I will go ahead and link it down below. I gave it 4 stars. I did knock off some points because it does utilize some of my least favorite tropes, and I did have some issues with some of the characters who I used to love in the past, but overall I really enjoyed this book. Next book I picked up is Hawk Song by Amelia Atwater Rhodes. This is the first book in the Keisha Raw series, and this is actually the only one that I'm really a huge fan of. This book follows a girl named Danica Chardet, and she is an avian shapeshifter, meaning that when she is in her human form, she looks like a person except she has feathers naturally growing out of her head. She can also shapeshift into a hawk, and there's this whole family of royalty, and she is the princess of the avians. They have been in a centuries-long war with the Serpiente, who are snake shapeshifters. This story takes place as the war kind of comes to a head. Nobody really knows why they've been fighting all this time, but they just keep doing it because it's what they've always done, and there's so much bad blood because everybody has killed everybody else. Plot of this story follows Danica as she and Zane Cobriana, the prince of the Serpiente, come to a meeting to discuss whether or not there is a way to basically create a peace between them. The mitigators of this meeting suggest that a royal wedding between the two would be sufficient. So this becomes a story of an arranged marriage and whether or not they can convince their people that it's not just for political gain, but it's actually for love. Not only does it have a romance love story in it, but it also has a bunch of assassins and a bunch of unrest amongst their peoples who do not want this marriage to succeed. I love this book. I really, really enjoy it. I give it 5 stars every time. My only complaint is that it's not very long. It's only like 240 pages. Yeah, it's exactly 243 pages. And while it's very well written and very entertaining and you get to love the 2 main characters, Zane and Danica, I do wish that it was a little bit longer because we don't really get to spend a lot of time with them after kind of the big climax. The next book I picked up this month is The Book of Ivy by Amy Engel. This is the first book in the Ivy duology, following a girl named Ivy who lives in a world that has been destroyed by a nuclear war. Some of the few survivors came together to create this town, and at one point in the history, about 100 years ago, the 2 sides got into a war over how to rule it, and one side won and one side lost. Every year, the daughters of the losing side are forced to marry the sons of the winning side to try to keep the tides in line and to try to create an image of unification. Ivy is the direct descendant of the founder of the town, therefore she is kind of like the political poster child and is going to be married off to the president of the town's son. But what nobody knows is that Ivy has been trained that she is going to assassinate him. I really enjoyed the story. I gave it 3 stars because it was very fun, it was very fast-paced, but I wasn't very clear on Ivy's motivations. Like, it was more told than shown why she was choosing to do what she was doing, and a lot of the time I felt like it could have been fleshed out more what her motivations were as far as what was going on. I never really felt connected to Bishop, the main guy, and overall I just felt like there wasn't enough emotionality in the story for it to really grip me as much as I wanted it to, but I will be continuing on with this duology. And the final book I picked up this month is one of my favorite books. It's another reread, and that is Heir Apparent by Vivian van Velde. This book is the second in the Rasmussen Enterprises series. I'm not really sure. It's essentially just a bunch of companion novels. This is the only one I've read, and I love this story. I read it in middle school, and I loved it. I read it a couple times in high school, and I loved it. I just read it, and I loved it. It's a book that I think is really great if it's up your alley. This book follows a girl named Janine Belisario, who for her 14th birthday received a gift card to go to Rasmussen Enterprises, which is essentially a video game arcade, and she wants to play a virtual reality game there. This is set in the future where there is a lot more technology, like buses can talk and understand what you're saying to them. They're not intelligent, like it's a definite AI interaction, but overall it is a futuristic world to kind of make it more believable. In this world, there is a group of people called CPOC who are opposed to children playing virtual reality games or watching anything without a G rating. Janine, for her birthday, goes to this arcade and decides to play a game called Heir Apparent. The theme of Heir Apparent is that you are a sheepherder's child who discovers that you are actually the king's secret bastard child. The king has died and has appointed you to be his heir. So the main character has to travel to the palace and overcome a bunch of different things such as peasant unrest, barbarian hordes, and the 3 legitimate sons of the king and his former queen. As if that's not stressful enough, in Janine's very first round of this game, CPOC breaks into the facility and damages a bunch of the games, and she is informed that because of this damage, there is no way for them to pull her out of the game before she has beaten it without harming her, and the backup safeguards on this game can only keep her functioning for a little while. So basically, if she doesn't beat this game in a short amount of time, she is going to die. If you're a fan of role-playing games, if you like video games, choose your own adventure, you're definitely going to enjoy this book. If you like sci-fi, I think you'll enjoy it. I really, really love this story. I love the characters in this story. I love the repetitiveness of this story because, like all video games, when you die, you have to go back to the beginning and start over and go through all those annoying, boring interactions again and again and again until you can move forward, and that is what Janine has to do over and over again. But her kind of insight into it and the way she interacts with everything around her makes even the most repetitive scenarios seem brand new, and I really love the story. It kind of tackles all of this with a good sense of humor, so while it seems like it should be like a really stressful book, it's actually very, very funny. Every time she makes different choices, she does different things, she allies herself with a different prince, and I just really love this book. I really recommend it if you haven't read it already. I know it's not very well known, and I really wish it was, because quite frankly, this is a book that I wish was made into a movie. Oh my gosh, I love this book so much. I want it to be a movie or a TV show. It would just be perfect. Sadly, this is a library book. I have not yet accumulated a copy of this novel. These were the books that I read this month of February, and now we're going to get into my March TBR. In no particular order, one of the books that I want to read this month is The Readers of Broken Wheel Recommend by Katarina Bivald. This book follows a woman from Sweden who has a book club pen pal type person living in Iowa, and she agrees to go and meet this person in Iowa. But when she gets there, she discovers that her pen pal has died. But she's stuck there, and she gets the idea that she is going to buy one of the crumbling storefronts and open a bookstore comprised entirely of the books in her dead pen pal's home. I think that it sounded really cute, and I read a couple of pages out of the middle, and it sounded really intriguing, so I definitely want to get into this one. It's like nothing I've ever read before, and I think that's great. The next book I want to read this month is Lady Midnight by Cassandra Clare. This is the first book in the Dark Artifices trilogy, following a couple of characters that we met in the final book in the Mortal Instruments series. I'm really looking forward to this book. I think it's going to be very entertaining. I really did enjoy the characters and their interactions in City of Heavenly Fire, so I'm really excited excited to get into it. The next book that I want to pick up is The Revolution of Ivy by Amy Engel. This is the second book in the Book of Ivy duology. The next book that I want to pick up is Rebel of the Sands by Alwyn Hamilton. This book follows a girl who lives in like a magical desert, and it's kind of feels like it's got some Arabic themes in there. And essentially she is living with her aunt and her uncle, and her mother is dead, and she's just living there trying to go about her life. But then she overhears her uncle saying that he plans to marry her and make her one of his wives. And so she decides that she wants out of there, and she enters into this sharpshooting contest because she's secretly really great at sharpshooting. And she meets this foreigner, and my understanding is that essentially they get caught up and accused of treason, so she runs away with him to escape these magical armies across the desert. I don't really know too much what it's about. All I know is that the publisher posted the first two chapters of this book on their Facebook. I read them, I was hooked, and I can't wait for this book to come out so that I can read it, and I'm really, really looking forward to it. And the last book that I definitively want to read this month is The Winner's Kiss by Marie Rutkowski. This is the third and final book in the Winner's Trilogy following a girl named Kestrel. I can't really get into the synopsis of this because obviously it's the third book in the trilogy. I read an excerpt of this book about a month or two ago, and it gutted me because it's just like, why did I read that? It's so good, and I have to wait for the book, and I'm so excited because this is one of my favorite trilogies, and the second book was even better than the first one, and I can't. But I am really friggin' excited. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Go ahead and comment down below. Let me know which of these books you've read, which ones you want to read, what you thought of them if you have read them, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.